Right, let's have a look, see how it goes together, or comes apart, to be more exact. One, two, three, four, five screws from the looks of it, unless there's one underneath the battery. Too big. Just right. So say, I expect that camera person is supposed to pop up and down, and I think that door is supposed to open. You see that? Xiong Sheng. I don't know how you pronounce that, obviously. Always one that doesn't want to drop out, and then it drops out when you're doing something else and you lose it. Right, focus back there again. Okay, be a little bit careful. Yeah, said that screw would drop out. So we've got a loose circuit board there, speaker there, wires that are probably gonna break. Oh, if we do it the other way around. Yeah, they all reach. Right, we have got a lot going on in here. That bit there looks like it all, yeah, should slide backwards and forwards. And that wood operate the door. Can I push that? So the door would open. Gull wing style. Ah, there we are, that's broken just there. I'll zoom in a bit closer so we can see that that's broken. Anything else broken? I'd really like to not have the speaker going. Oh, I think, thinking about it, does that go? No, it doesn't. I thought there might have been a sound off position. So if I turn that on. How about if I stick that over the speaker? That might make it a little bit quieter. Only a tiny bit. Okay, let's try and work out what else isn't working. Clearly, this is supposed to go backwards and forwards. what would drive it backwards and forwards? Somebody's alarm going off outside. I don't see anything on the top here that would go backwards and forwards, or that would drive that backwards and forwards. I am looking just there and that screw is loose. It's not loose, but it's not fully home either. And that looks, not sure if that's split or not under there. But certainly if that went back, it feels like it should click in place. There's a little click noise. How about, as that turns round, that moves that, we're going to have that sound on again. Ah, I can see. This is broken. It looks like there should be a lever coming over there. Operated by that cam. Just here. Right, there was no pieces fell out as I opened it. So whatever the missing piece is, all we can do is guess that there's definitely an arm missing just there. That piece is broken. There should be an arm coming across here somehow. If that arm came across, that would push this slot. Yeah, that's sort of spring-loaded, although I think the spring is broken. Ah, no, the spring isn't broken. Whatever that arm is would link up with that spring. Obviously, I could 3D print something to fit. The problem is I don't know what it looks like. And as I say, this piece is also broken just here. Might be able to just glue that back together, although gluing this plastic never ever works well. Let's take this off. This is going to be a much longer video than intended. I mean, we can see inside it, but we can't actually fix it in one quick video. All right, clearly, can we come up and focus? There we are. Oh, don't stay in focus, come on. Yeah, that bit there, clearly there was an arm coming up here that's broken off. And I think it probably lined up with that spring as well. But all I can do is just guess. Yeah. There's no telltale piece of plastic laying around in there or rattling around in there. I could take some measurements. And clearly the arm's going to come across here and interact with that cam. But how it interacts with it. Turn it on again. I could just short that out. Put a resistor across it, or just unwire it. That's going to be the actual sound chip, isn't it? In there. In that little black blob. I think. Yeah, it's got to be, because that's what goes directly to the speaker. Right, what else can we look at while we're looking here? Can we change the colour? Oh, yes, that's much better. Right, very... I'll just go over that again now that I've brightened it up. That bit is the broken bit. Somehow there would be an arm on there that interacts with that cam going round, and that will then push this backwards and forwards. At the same time, with the other gears there, we're operating this, which is what makes the camera person turn side to side. And underneath will be, well, that's the motor. But there'll be a gear shaft going down to a gear on the axle there. So standard bump and go. When it can go forwards, the wheels will drive it forwards. When it can't go forwards, then the way the gears come vertically down onto the gearbox, they'll tend to turn it. And as soon as they've turned it, obviously it's not pushing against whatever was bumping into it, and it will drive off in a different angle. And once it's free to go again, it will straighten itself up. I have taken those apart in the past, so I'm not going to worry about it just now. I'm more interested in, can we fix that? That's probably a long enough video for now. I'll take some measurements. I'll just use my imagination. And we'll see if we can get something that might actually move it. Just thought I'd do a bit more close up. So we can see some of the detail. That's a flashing LED in her camera. Down there, that bit actually makes the windscreen wipers turn. There's a peg sticking down that no doubt goes in that slot just there. And that's the bit I said was broken, just there. Which is what turns this one side to side. That That's the arm that's broken that I'm talking about, interacts with that blue gear. That bit there pushes against the door lever down there somewhere, and I can see there's a little hook there. I should think that door is spring loaded, or should be. And the spring is missing, I would guess. Or, yeah, no, I think that's what that is. Up under there, circuit board for the LEDs, the red LEDs on the back. That's the wiring for the headlight LEDs. That's the motor. We could take it all apart and have a look at the whatever gearbox is under there. And then I just push that along. I can't do it with one hand. There you go, that's what pops her down out of the way. I'm pretty sure that little circuit board there with the hole in it should be screwed down onto there. But the wires aren't long enough. It can't physically get there with the speaker where it is. If we put the speaker, turned it round 180 degrees, those wires would be over that side, and then it would probably fit. I reckon somebody's had this apart, and it wasn't me. Right, found a screw. Turn the speaker round so that all holds that in place nicely. Looking from this angle, I can see the hook on there and the hook on there. So that's where there should be a spring going through to hold the door closed. I would imagine very similar spring to that one. I've just realised the other door is supposed to open. I thought it was just one door opened, and that one we can see is broken, but we can see the spring. So that bracket just there is broken. So clearly both doors are supposed to open. Yeah, both supposed to open, but I reckon this one's glued shut. Yeah, that's what's happened there. So the hinge inside is broken, so somebody's glued this one shut. Right, I've pinched that spring from the other side, so at least this door should open and close. Can't do much about the other side because it's glued shut. Of course, I was talking about the windscreen wipers going side to side. It probably wasn't clear. These are broken as well. Obviously, the wiper blades should be coming up here. So they're broken. And they're heat welded inside, I suppose is the way to put it. Potentially I could do something about that. I'd just be more interested in trying to fix the mechanism for it going up and down. Thanks for watching. If you want more information, check down below in the video description. If you like this video, you might like this one up here. And if you want to subscribe, you can check out my channel over here. Up here,
is my latest video on my channel, and down here is a video playlist associated with the video you've just watched. Thanks again for watching.